Solid, liquid, gas.
Supersolid, superfluid.
Or Bose-Einstein condensate.
That one is super cool.
It is plus plasma.
But we haven't even gotten started yet. We truly live in the future.
You ready, T?
Ready.
Scientists have created yet another state of matter.
Woo!
Yay!
It's called a supersolid, and while it sounds like a solid, it's...
It's not. A supersolid is basically a superfluid that got its crap together.
And by crap, you mean molecules.
I do. The researchers who created the new state of matter took a Bose-Einstein condensate made of sodium gas and used lasers to cool it to near absolute zero.
The atoms are moving extremely slowly. A BEC is a special phase of matter created in 2001, winning researchers the Nobel Prize for physics.
Once cooled to a BEC, the sodium flowed with zero friction. It's like a superfluid.
A superfluid,
which is awesome. The BEC was also superconductive, meaning its electrons move through it with zero resistance. There are numerous scientific benefits to these two conditions, but we're not here to talk about that.
In this case, the scientists kept cooling that sodium, and at some point it arranged into a non-crystalline solid.
The scientists called it a superfluid flow with long-range spatial periodicity of a solid.
Those are some fancy science words.
They sure are. Essentially, think of it like a coffee cup filled with a frictionless superconducting gel that if you could stir it, would never stop going around.
Delicious. The fluid didn't suddenly become hard. Instead, it's not exactly solid. Think of it like a gel. It's a fluid, but it behaves like a solid.
They've still got a lot to learn about these fluids slash solids, but according to their paper, their supersolid, quote, establishes a system with continuous symmetry-breaking properties, associated collective excitations, and superfluid behavior.
Let's break that down.
That's a lot, yeah.
Superfluid behavior you get, we just explained it, frictionless superconductor.
Collective excitations is a fancy way to say quasi-particles. Quasi-particles are a group of particles that behave as if they're one because their parts are interacting somehow.
And then there's symmetry breaking.
That's also describing particle movement. Normally, in quantum mechanics, symmetry is a big deal. Breaking it, a bigger deal.
At the moment, it continues that old saying, the closer you look, the stranger things get.
But come on, do we really have six states of matter now? No, we don't. We have way more. The states of matter, solid, liquid, and gas that you've been living with your whole life were never all there were.
It's kind of like when you're learning math. First, you're taught numbers. Then they tell you there are infinitely many numbers. Then, as if they're just messing with you, they tell you there are infinite negative numbers too.
And then you find out there are irrational numbers and imaginary numbers, and you can do calculations with infinities and embedded equations into each other, and yeah, matters like that.
So yes, solid, liquid, gas, and plasma exist, but it's really about molecular arrangement. Solids are interacting heavily, liquids are more loosey-goosey, and gases are just barely interacting, while plasma is free. It can do anything. But on top of those four, there are several more states of matter.
Cold ones like the Bose-Einstein condensate and supersolid, and hot ones like electron degenerate matter, free particles found in white dwarf stars, or the theorized stranger matter, possibly found in neutron stars.
Plus, of course, time crystals, which have low energy states and weird effects across time symmetry.
I mean, we should just do a whole video about states of matter, right?
Yeah, we probably should. Basically. Bottom line, we have a new state of matter, yay, but we don't have six or seven. We have at least a dozen. They're just more out there, experimental, laboratory only, or extreme kinds of matter.
Our universe? It's pretty awesome.
Boom diada.
Shakalaka. Look, everyone, if you want to know more about states of matter, watch this video about time crystals. It'll give you a nice headache, or maybe it already has. Do you have an itch for science to answer? That's why we're here. Tell us in the comments, subscribe for more, and thanks for watching Seeker.
Bye.
Bye.